Guys, preheated waffle iron. So I preheated the waffle iron at approximately around 200 degrees Celsius. This is nice batter. That steam which is coming out, right, that is basically all the carbonation from the beer and the amount of baking powder that we put inside. So without being tempted to open this, just leave it in there, let it cook for about 2.5 minutes. So we put a nice timer here. The reason I put this aluminium foil is that dirt doesn't fall on it, otherwise it's pretty much okay. Let it, you know, if you don't want to use this, you can just avoid that. So basically that's what it looks like. So the reason we do these demos is again so that you can start baking at home, start doing things at home. So you don't have to, you know, you don't always have to come out to learn. You can always learn at home as well. As I mentioned to you, if you don't have one of these waffle irons, this batter can also be cooked on top of a normal skillet pan or a normal non-stick pan. You can cook it on top of that as well. This is almost there now. I'm still not going to. So a lot of times you'll be tempted to keep checking it again and again. Don't do that. Make sure it goes for the full time of 2 minutes. Only then check it. Nice good amount of steam coming out here as well now. It's almost there. This is one of the good things about these machines is that they come with timers. If you don't have a professional machine, as I mentioned, you can get one of those non-professional machines as well, domestic grade machines. Those are pretty good. They'll give you a slightly flatter waffle, but it's good enough. You hear the bell, just check it. Open it gently. So here you have your yummy ragi waffle ready. I'm just going to pop it out. I use a little spoon. I'm going to put it onto this cooling tray here. In this cooling tray, it's easier for it to cool down. Once it's cool, then you can easily serve it. Ideally, never serve it when it's just out of the waffle iron. We're going to go with the second one while I plate up the first one. Again, a little bit of oil. Don't forget to add a little bit of oil. Oil is always required. Nice good stir inside again. You can see the goodness of the ragi coming out of this. You know, it's like ragi's right there. Just cover it up totally like this and let it cook. Again, give it a timer. So 2.5 minute timer. So what we're going to do is we've got a little bit of the sauce in the left. So we're going to plating again, simple waffle. There are many ways to plate it, but for me the easiest way to plate it is basically just have it with some sauce. Just pour your sauce on top. It's good beer sauce, beer chocolate sauce. It goes very well with this particular product. I'm just going to douse that with that. So we've got many of you don't know how to make ice cream at home. We'll be covering that in one of the sessions, in the future sessions. But for those who don't know how to do that, I have a very simple solution for you. Just put a choco bar on top of this. So we'll be showing you those pictures after we do this waffle. We'll be doing a choco bar waffle as well. So that just is a simple waffle with a choco bar on top. quite simple. Okay, this is on a timer. Let it go for a timer. So this is, I'm just going to leave you for a minute, and I'm going to get a little bit of icing sugar so we can dust the icing sugar on top of this. Give me a minute. Take a little bit of, I don't know if you can see that, can you see it? Yeah. Just dust it a little bit of. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is your beer waffle. We have the next one ready. Again, we're just going to toss it out. These waffles, again, are very simple to make. So I can just fire up the third one as well. Very simple to make the waffle. So I don't know if you can come closer and just check. What I'm doing is I'm just putting a little bit of oil on the top and on the bottom. So the reason we do the oil is because the oil makes it come off the pan very easily. Waffles there. Just be a little stingy and take everything out. Spread it down. I will close this. Again, give it a timer of 3 minutes. 2 minutes, sorry. So this waffle also is ready to go. We're going to serve this with a little bit of icing sugar. Again, this has just come out of the waffle iron. So give it a minute or two. Let it relax outside for some time. Then just keep cooking. And if you can get the smell, this is really good smell of beer coming. The entire room is smelling like a beer house right now. This you can easily dig into it. While that is baking, then dig into that. You can just try that. You can try it. It's a very good beer waffle. That's number one. This we are not putting any beer sauce. We're just going to put a little bit of icing sugar on top. It's still taking a minute.
Last popular is a bit flattish. We had a little less batter to put, but that's pretty okay. We're not here to make complicated pastry. We're here to make simple pastry. And simple pastry doesn't need too much of artwork. It's just simple stuff that you can eat. And if you're happy, it gives you a lot of satisfaction when you eat it. So here are our two versions of the beer waffle made with this beer. Thanks for joining us today. If you need more, if you want to really start baking, I would say don't wait for an excuse. Just do whatever comes to you. It's really simple stuff, complicated stuff. Just do whatever you can, because once you start baking, you will start growing from strength to strength, and you'll start getting better at things. This is something that's really simple. I just want to cover with. I've got beer waffles made a lot of it sounded a lot of fun, so let's do some beer waffles today. And we had a lot of beer with us, so we might as well we decided to use it up this way. If you don't like to use beer, as I said, this particular recipe you can just knock off the beer. You can just use more milk instead of that. That gives you an additional fluffiness as well. If you plan to make this product, so this product is going to be very soft. This waffle is going to be it's going to be on a softer side. What we've done is we've also replaced a lot of the maida, which is the flour. We've replaced it with nachni flour or millet flour or ragi. So you can use alternative flours if you want. Make it play with the recipe a little bit. These recipes are easy to play with. However, if you try to replace the egg here, you need to use a good quality egg replacer powder. If you're using milk-made or using trying to use any kind of a milk-based substitute, it doesn't work well. So I always recommend for you to use a good quality egg replacer powder in this particular recipe. You do get a lot of premixes in the market, so you can use those premixes in the market as well. Those premixes, however, are largely yeast-driven. This particular product is largely baking powder driven. So that is the basic difference between these two waffle batters. And one of the reasons that this particular batter is very popular when you do it in a quick service format. So if you want to do something like if you are a baker who has waffle stations at a mall or in a catering establishment or some kind of outdoor catering scenario, then this particular recipe serves you better than the other one. Apart from this, you have other waffles as well. This is just the start. If you want to start baking waffles, every Saturday, Sunday, the healthiest breakfast, I would say you can start doing crazy amount of stuff with that. And this is what we've done is a sweet waffle. If you don't like sweet waffles, you can also do savory waffles. It doesn't really, waffle doesn't really always have to be sweet. It can be savory as well. So that's all for today, guys. Thanks so much for joining us. We're going to have a short session today. And if you have any doubts, as I said, you can just send us a message on 98202-20912. Also, what you can do is you can like our Instagram page and send us messages on Instagram as well. We get to reply most of them, so that shouldn't be a problem. The other thing is also if you're on Facebook, you can like our page Foodie Breaks India. Foodie Breaks, that's FOODY. Not DYBREAKS, Foodie Breaks India. If you can like our page, then you get a lot of updates on what we keep doing. And this recipe and post also going to be live on the page. So if you want to check that out, please go ahead and feel free to do so. If you have any issues with this product, although it's really simple, do voice it with a picture if you can, so that I'll know what's going wrong. That'll be all for today. Thanks so much for joining us, and I hope to see you guys next week with another crazy video. So we'll let you know by Monday what we're planning to do next week. And it's going to be really simple again. We don't not get complicated things. Simple stuff, so you guys can start your baking journey with us. Thanks so much for joining us. Bye bye.
Today's session today. Sorry, we're a little bit late, but we want to start with a session with beer waffles. Beer waffles is a very simple product that we're doing today. Really something that you will love to do at home. If you don't have a waffle machine like that, like a professional waffle machine. If you don't have a waffle machine like this, then what I would advise is you can even go in for one of those less expensive waffle machines that you get at home. That also is possible. One of the other things that I wanted to mention today is that the kind of baking that we're doing today is an assisted baking.
Now, in the event that you do not want to do this, you can also make pancakes in your normal pan at home. You can use the same batter to make pancakes as well. They turn out pretty well as well. Cool. Let's start without any further delay. So, you've got all the equipment ready. Need all the equipment here so that you can get all this done. Whatever we're using here, we're not going to be, you know, it's not something that is very hi-fi. All basic stuff, nothing very complicated. So we'll start first by browning the butter. So you can bring the camera here. So we're going to brown the butter. Just brown it so it gets a little bit of a caramel color. So what we're doing is basically just caramelizing the butter. We've added a little oil here so that the butter doesn't get totally burnt and the caramelizing process is very uniform. Now this is, I'm doing it on a higher heat, but if you notice here, it's starting to bubble. Putting it here. It's starting to bubble. And we're going to let it bubble till it starts getting a little bit of a brown color coming through. This brown color that's going to come through is basically going to be all that butter starting to get caramelized. One of the ideal things in this recipe is to use flavored oils if you can, or if you can use even groundnut oil, that will be really better. Nice brown butter. We keep it on the side here. The next thing we're doing is we're making a small sauce. Let that cool for some time. We're going to be making a sauce with some of the white beer. So I've got some chocolate ganache here. Now this ganache we have pre-made. So this ganache is basically one part of chocolate and one part of cream, which is 100 grams of chocolate compound. We've used couverture here. So this is a Mordic couverture. You can also use a compound. It's not a problem. We've used 100 grams of chocolate couverture as well as we've used 100 grams of Amul cream. So that I'm going to just put inside the, I'm just going to microwave this so that it gets a little bit of, it'll be a little melted. Putting in the microwave for about 30 seconds. Sometimes it takes 30 seconds, sometimes it takes one minute, no problem, don't worry. This recipe is already live on our Facebook page, that's facebook.com/foodiebreaksindia. If you're looking for the recipe, it's already live there along with the sauce. In the sauce, I'm going to add a little bit of beer just to get a little bit of more flavor. You notice that the ganache is melted. Melted ganache, just mix it up. So it's chunky, a little bit slightly chunky. Now in this I'm going to put a little bit of beer. So I've got my liter jug here. I'm going to put about 100 ml of beer in this. So you see what I've done smartly is I've taken off all the froth. So I don't want there to be a lot of froth in the beer. Nice, give it a nice shake. Nice fruity aromas from this nice Simba beer.
If you don't like beer, you can use non-alcoholic beer. If you don't like beer at all, you can just omit the beer. So add about 100 ml in there. Mix it up. You're going to keep mixing it till it gets really delicious stuff. If you're around Porurim, you can come and try it today. You're not there tomorrow. But if you're not around here, then you can try it at home. Really yum stuff. So this is your ganache ready to go. Or rather, now it's your chocolate choco beer sauce, which is ready to go. So we're going to keep it on the side. So your sauce is ready. Your beer is not required unless you want to drink it. We're going to start making the batter now. So making the batter, I'm going to take out my container, which has got the dry ingredients. Put it in there. Using a whisk, I'm going to first whisk it up. In this, there is flour, there is baking powder, there is nachni flour, which is ragi, and there is also a touch of sugar. So there are four things that have gone into this. Now we've got the liquids. So in the liquids, I'm going to show you one by one. In the liquids, you have your egg, you have your milk. So I'm going to combine the egg and the milk together. The egg and the milk is combined together. And I'm going to keep whisking this, and I'm going to then combine the beer into that. So it's like a healthy concoction of everything in one. So in this, now you have egg, you have vanilla essence, you have milk, and you have beer. Mix it up, combine it into this. Once all the liquids have gone in, you have to manually mix it up like that. If you have one of the KitchenAid machines, you can use a KitchenAid machine with a paddle attachment, but nothing beats mixing it by hand. Your nice stir. You get a nice fruity aroma from this beer. We use craft beer because craft beer gives us very good flavors. But if you use a normal beer, it will work equally fine. When I mean a normal beer, I mean, you know, any of your normal company, your regular beers, regular lagers, or any kind of commercial beer that you drink in the market. You can drink any one of those, no problem. Those also give you an equally good product. But a nice white beer gives you a nice good flavor. Now this is done, I'm going to add in my caramelized butter. Just get a nice shake and get everything in there. In order to mix it up better, use your rubber spatula and get everything out. Once everything is out, again just give it a nice mix. And your batter is ready. Now in a minute, I'm going to start taking questions. If you have any questions, please let me know. If you have no questions, we'll take a small break. I'm going to put this for wash. And we're going to quickly strain this mix as well. So what I don't need, I'm just going to get rid of it now. I don't need all of these things, just keep it on the back. What I need, I'll hold on to. I need the sauce, I'm going to keep the sauce around here. We need to get rid of this as well, so we'll put it at the back. Always keep what you require. What you don't require, just get rid of it so that it doesn't clog your kitchen. You don't have trash around your place, you know. That makes a big problem when you're cooking.
shifting attention to this particular area now. So I'm starting to heat this particular waffle iron. It's going to take about 5 minutes. In that 5 minutes, this batter is going to relax and this is going to heat up. So that's like a good time to maintain if you're doing that. If you're not, if you don't do that, sometimes the waffle starts to get very fluffy and it doesn't have enough time to rest the carbonation inside, and that creates a little bit of a problem. So I'm going to quickly strain this out. Strain it, I'm using a fine strainer. Just use a fine strainer. Keep a little bit of distance from the strainer, between the strainer and the jar, the measuring jar, so that you can smartly get everything inside the jar directly. Now this particular batter, the recipe which is given in your on the Facebook page, I have actually half that recipe for this particular